Hello and welcome to my podcast, Conversations with Cornelius, where I, Cornelius Patrick O'Sullivan, discuss, chat and hypothesize on all things from fatherhood, marriage, comedy and everything else in between. From time to time, there will be special guests, but mostly it's going to be me and some regular contributors, including my main squeeze, Noelle Patricia O'Sullivan, a.k.a. The Wife. So sit back, relax and enjoy Conversations with Cornelius. Your mic is on, and is this episode. Ladies and gentlemen,
we're here.
Welcome back to another episode of Conversations with Cornelius. I am your host, Cornelius Patrick O'Sullivan. As I said to Harvey today, Danger is my middle name. Well, it's not Danger, it's actually Patrick, but I'm looking into changing it into Danger, you know?
Bless.
And then he said to me, "You can't have that as your middle name, Dad. My middle name is Danger." And I was like, "No, your fucking brother's middle name is Danger. you're not dangerous. You're actually quite the opposite of dangerous, Harvey. You're quite a beautiful child." But anyway, where am I?
I hear I say.
Where are we? We are in the sitting room.
Doesn't quite have the same ring to the John Hume Wall
Room. The John Hume Wall Room is adjacent to us, but I'm in the sitting room. I'm looking at a big massive hole in the roof that has been there since before COVID that we need to get fixed. That's what I'm looking at now. And it's Sunday. What time is it? It's 20 to 10. This podcast is coming out in the morning. The Patreon went out earlier on today. I do a Patreon here every single week now, guys, if you're interested, with the Queen here beside me. The Patreon is an exclusive podcast. It's called Cornelius and the Queen. There's about 4 episodes on it. And we have an introductory price of only €2.50 at the moment. The link is in the description here. So you'll be able to get that if you're interested in listening to myself and the Queen waffle on. And
We better make this a decent podcast, so to get them over.
Yeah, well, that's going to be difficult considering how hungover you are.
I know.
You're very hungover. We'll get into that later on. But that's fine too. Do you know what? Fucking be hungover.
Be who you want to be, Cornelius.
Be who you want to be, and don't let anybody bring you down. And just make sure to sprinkle your positivity into every room you saunter. Because your bliss...
So I have to put up with now, people?
You don't have to put up with much. You just have to put up with yourself. But yeah, we have a Patreon.
And our children.
Noelle left her job there a couple of weeks ago, or a couple of months ago, and we're on the breadline.
Stop with you.
And we're doing a Patreon exclusive podcast, because we've got the time to do it, really, I suppose.
Mm.
And it's going great. And yeah. Anyway, that's not what I was trying to talk. I was just kind of saying, how did I get onto that?
I don't know.
Where am I?
Remember, we did a podcast like months ago, maybe even years at this stage. And like, it was...
We're at the podcast years now, the two of us.
Years now. And it was like, how many times can you mention Patreon in the episode? I'd say it was to be just when we set up the Patreon.
Patreon.
Say it's like the same now, Patreon.
And I wouldn't mind.
Ding, ding.
But this Patreon has been set up with over 2 years.
That's
do you know what I mean?
Saying.
Like,
yeah,
I never plug it. I fucking, like, I should have been, because other people who have podcasts literally pimp the shit out. Like,
do they?
They do, and you have to. Like, I mean, we're creating content there, right? This is the way I look at it now, right? And it's a tough sell for some people, right? But we are creating content. What do you call that? What do you call it? Good content or bad content? It is being created. It takes time. It takes batteries. It takes electricity. It takes microphones and Zoom boxes. It takes me. Like, I prep. I do all the prep. You're luckily, you just have to look pretty and talk, you know? And you're...
Tonight I'll manage to talk.
Well, you're looking very pretty as well.
Aw, thanks, Queen.
I think you're only beautiful. I think you're glowing. You
that's
know?
Just with the remnants of last night's makeup.
Well, I just had a big joint as well, and I'm drinking a bit of wine, so maybe, like, I'm looking... Maybe
there's lots of tinted glasses going on there.
I could have the beer goggles on.
There's not just rose, there's rainbow.
The rainbow. Don't try and bring me down, because your negativity isn't going to work with me.
Oh, my God.
Today,
wouldn't
tomorrow,
you like to
or
stab
next
him
week.
Sometimes?
I'm standing up for myself now. I don't have to listen to this shit. Fuck you. So what's going on in my mind? I tell you now, right? What's going on in my mind at the moment? Doubts.
Oh.
Yeah, Jesus. I have doubts. I have a lot of fear. And I have frustrations. They're and you heavy. Know, all very heavy. I have been having them on my shoulders there, particularly in the last 10 to 14 days. And
are you on?
I beg your pardon?
Are you due on?
My period? No, sure, I'm a man. I don't have periods at all.
Maybe you're following the moon.
Maybe it's the moon cycle. Stop taking the piss out of the moon.
Stop. That is very good. Sounds so annoying. Sounds annoying from here. Never mind somebody listening to an earphone or something.
But I have all these things. I'll tell you, so I'm on my holidays. I'm on my 10 days. I took 10 days holidays. I haven't done a gig in coming on to, I don't know, 7 or 8 days, 8 days or 9 days now. And I'm about to go on tour, and fucking club has been taking all my energy along with trying to write my own show, and I have my own show debuting in The Everyman next year, and that's a big show, and that's coming on sale soon, and I have all these doubts. I'm like kind of imposter syndrome. I'm like, oh god, am I ready? Am I good? Am I actually even good? Am I any good? Like, am I?
And what do you think that's driven by? Like, is
so
it?
So I'll tell you why I think. Well, it's driven by in a minute, right?
But all like, happening in a minute.
But no, because it's like I'm genuinely having this fucking confidence of crisis. Did a couple of gigs, then did a gig there down in Whitechurch last 2 weeks ago. Fucking horror gig, like where there was like it was. Remember that?
Beour
was up the front.
Else,
not Whitechurch, Whitegate, not Whitegate. I can't think of the name of the place anyway.
Somewhere.
And it kind of knocked me a small bit, and then that was my second last gig. The next gig was in the Coco, and I was only hosting, and that went well. But like, then I'm just like fucking other people. Then I'm watching other people as well, looking at other people's success, you know, peers of mine. And then anytime I say anything to anyone else, they're all, "What are you talking about? You're fucking, you're very successful." You know what I mean? Like, but I'm just like these.
That's probably a natural thing, though.
Maybe it's a natural thing.
Natural enough.
Maybe it's the moon. I don't know. But what I think, I think. I think it's because I'm on holidays. I swear to God, fucking time to think about shit.
I don't know if there'll be much time to think now this week. It was a very busy week.
It was busy, but like for example, I had all day yesterday. You were gone all day
yesterday.
Yeah,
true. Maybe it was just busy for me.
You know,
the last
and even
eight
when
days.
We were on holidays, there was plenty of time for contemplation. Like, I used to take the dog for a walk in the mornings and stuff like that. I know we had, you know, like an unbelievable experience on our holidays. Unbelievable. But look, listen, lads, if you want to hear about the holiday, you're going to have to go on to Patreon.
Because it's 100, not 100, that's when I'm talking with the kids, minutes. It's an hour and 20 minutes or something.
An hour talked. And 20 minutes. And like we went camping for the very first time as a family with our two smallies and our dog, the five of us. And honestly, no, lads, we do not look like campers.
No, we definitely didn't. We were uncamping.
Yeah, but we threw ourselves into balls and all, or in your case, vagina. And or ovaries, we'll say balls and ovaries and all. We went all in, and the day we came back, for fear that we would forget, we recorded the podcast, the Patreon podcast, and it's all up there now on our Patreon for less than the price of a cup of coffee, guys. Do you know what I mean? For less than the price of a cup of coffee, $2.50 a month. Sure, what would you be doing if you were out there? Buy us a coffee. Do you know what I mean? Anyway, that's.
But we don't actually need it. Just disclaimer.
We'll take it. Like we're creating. No, like happy. Thank you more, please. Like this is the thing. I think you have to fucking justify it. I think you have to go. Yeah, look, listen. If you want that, there you go. Have it.
There's more content. Forgive me, content. But there's more.
And there's a load of it. Go back and listen to it. And I tell you this now, lads. There's about fucking 20 or 30 other podcasts on it as well, for all the patrons that have been on. You know, on board over the last couple of years. So you have access to all of them
all
as well.
All the back stuff.
All the back catalogue.
Not just the Queen.
Not just four episodes. So you're actually like getting in on episodes. So, and there's some cracking episodes with regular podcast guests on this. So do you know what I mean? It'd be worth your while. Sign the fuck up. If you're over in America, if you're in England now, right? Just sign up. Sign up. Just do it. I have a few people listening in the Maldives. Lads, I don't know what you're doing. Yeah, in the Maldives.
Do you know who they are?
I haven't a clue. We can check on the analytics. You can see where.
Oh, I remember. Like, yeah, but I didn't realise that there was people in the Maldives.
No, I will say we have patrons from Canada. We have patrons from America. We have patrons from, I think, Australia. And we've loads of friends and family. And we're not begging, like, you know, don't give it to us if you don't want to. But you know what I mean? If you do like the podcast and you want to hear myself
more.
And Noel every week, talking about every week. you know, you can, and it's just 250. So anyway, but I'm just going back to myself and my fears and my frustrations.
Yeah, go back to yourself.
And I'm just feeling like, you know, and I'm definitely the woman in this relationship, right? Like the traditional woman, like I'm always talking about my feelings, and you're like, would you ever fuck off?
Grant.
You're Grant. I said to you one time, like, do you ever kind of get melancholy or stuff like this? It was good about 2 or 3 years ago, and in fairness, you were working at the time, and you just kind of looked at me as if I had, like, we were in the middle of COVID. I was the two lads, you were flat out at work, you just looked at me, you were like, fucking hell, what are you talking about?
Yeah, well, it was probably, the likelihood is, it was like probably the most inappropriate time to ask me something. Your situational awareness is absolutely shocking. And it was probably like one of the kids that was probably fucking changing Hunter with Harvey crying and like cooking a dinner. And you were like, do you ever feel like melancholy?
Do you know what's actually fucking hilarious about that? When you said my situational, what did you say?
Awareness
is shocking. I'm writing comedy about that with you and me at the moment. Just about how I'm completely oblivious to what's really going on. Like, do you know what I mean? There could be a death and I'd be like, are we going to have that ride tonight? So, like, do you know what I mean? And you'd be like, Connie, fucking, like, no, we're not. We're going to a removal. My fucking... I don't know. I don't want to put the hex on anyone.
I know what you mean. Yeah, but like we're going to removal, and that's what you're thinking.
And you're looking for the ride. Do you know what I mean? Or like, what I'm writing about is like I'm using the cinema as an excuse. So we're not going to the cinema tonight. No, we're not. My fucking Auntie Beatrix just passed away. Do you know what I mean? But anyway,
it's just like I always think of the time that you said it's not kind of quite situational awareness, but. I think it kind of sums you up. Was the time that a family member, one of their kids, was gone into hospital because they had a rash. And Connie genuinely asked him, did they try Sudocream? And they all thought he was taking the piss. I was like... He's not actually taking the piss. He's genuinely asking, did you try Sudocream? He's laced it on his legs here.
You brought it up now. My leg from my ankles right up to the top of my knees are covered in Sudocream because I went walking with my son today. When I say walking, we went actually jogging through the forest. Myself, my youngest son, and my dog triumphantly through the air.
I wish you could see him right now. He's got Sudocream all over his legs.
My fucking legs.
He has a gallon of wine and he's got a trough wrapped around his shoulders like a cape.
Just bring me just bring my who I want to be. You shouldn't really bring me down. I don't bring you down. But anyway, I'm going to try and get over that.
Sorry, yeah.
But I am. I'm trying because do you know what? I am fucking. I kind of had a realization. I was just cop the fuck on.
Drive on.
Get back to your affirmations. Get back to your habits. Fucking repeat the. Get back to the process, and get your head down. And
I think that's probably what it is, though. It's actually probably the amount of alcohol we've had.
We've had a lot of alcohol.
We have had
shit food as well, babe.
Yeah, we've had a week of.
On holidays, I suppose.
Yeah. And we've been out of routine for the whole of summer. And I actually think this summer has been the first summer that we've really felt the summer like...
Chaos.
Summer chaos because I'm off work.
Yeah.
So that routine is gone as well. Mm. So there's an...
Your job added a layer of routine to the house here that was almost regimented. Because like when Sam was in minding the boys, she had a very strict routine, plan for the day.
Like she was strict on them, but there was a very structured plan.
Structure. And she'd always, in fairness now, she'd always like... She'd have the gate up and I'd be able to like hear on the door so the lads wouldn't be in to annoy me. You know, when I'm working and stuff like that. And I'm not saying that that you're not doing a great job. You're doing a fantastic job. But, like, you could put the fucking gate up, like, do you know what I mean? Like,
into this turn.
No, but I'm just saying, they'd come, like, yes, stuff like that. So they, like, I could, like, and that's one thing about the holidays this week, right? And if you're interested to see how it went, lads, join the Patreon.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
But the holidays this week.
Sick of listening to him about it.
But genuinely, right? Hunter, remember I said to you, I said, the one thing I want to get out of this holiday is I want to get time with Hunter because I've been saying no to him so fucking much. He'd bust, I'd be in the middle of doing something. And you know yourself now, when you are doing something and you're trying to work, you know, in the middle of the day and your four-year-old is busting in on top of you. I don't care what environment you're working in. If you're working anywhere in the world and that's continuously happening.
And you're the belle of the ball now for him as well.
Yeah.
At the moment. Like with me around all the time, the shine is off me now, which is lovely. It's very freeing.
It's great. And I love it. But I felt coming into the holiday that I wasn't giving him that attention. I wasn't giving him the attention that he was requiring. Now, he was requiring a lot of attention. But I wanted to give it to him. And I fucking think I did that during the holiday. And I think, I put him to bed now tonight. I put the lads to bed tonight.
Well, aren't you fucking marvellous?
Well, I'm absolutely amazing. Like, and I tell you one thing for nothing. If you were on the podcast, and many's the night you have been, you always say it. And I'm always like, fucking hell, like, they must think I never put them to bed. Well, I put them to bed tonight. And as they were drifting off, I think I heard Hunter say, "Dad, you're the best at putting us to bed.
You can try it again now."
That's
tomorrow,
what he said. And I said, "I know, Hunter, but Mom must learn as well." and then he said, "You're right, Dad. She should put us to bed in future, even though you're the best and always will be." And I said, "Good night, Hunt." And he said, "Good night." And then I was just about to leave and Harvey said, "Dad." And I said, "Yeah, Harv. Do you know what Hunter said about you being the best?" I was like, "Yeah." "Well, I completely agree." and I went away then.
That's nice for you.
That's a true story.
Try it again now tomorrow and see if they say the same thing.
Trending topics with Cornelius Patrick O'Sullivan. But before we do that, I must introduce this week's guest to the stage. She's beautiful. She's energetic, but not tonight. She's marvelous. She's very good at Halloween. She'll give you a fright. Her name is Noelle, and she is the belle of the ball. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Noelle, Patricia, Old Sullivan, Nimaraku, and the crowd go wild.
Not able for you.
How are you?
How am I? I've been better now, Cornelius. I'm poisoned.
But you know what's absolutely brilliant about that, right?
What?
We have just started Trending Topics with Cornelius Patrick O'Sullivan. And the first trending topic is out. And relevant. You were out last night.
I was out. I was on rounds of Prosecco. When do you fucking go on rounds of Prosecco? With eight of us.
Yeah.
Is there seven or eight of us?
48.
Yeah, but it was great. Yeah. So I went to...
Where was it at?
With a gang from... We met... I would like to say we met during college, but they're not. I wasn't in college. We weren't in the same courses, but we've been friends for years. But we haven't... It was one of the girls' 40th, but we haven't seen each other. I've maybe bumped into two of them, like, sporadically over the last while. But, like, some of them I hadn't seen since before COVID, like.
Yeah.
So, and it was our first night out that I was out with them anyway in ages.
A gang
of
you.
Brilliant. Yeah.
I remember this 40th 10 years ago when it was a 30th. And it was the same girl, Ammo. She listens to this podcast. Shout out to Ammo. And I remember her 30th. I remember coming in to collect you at the 30th.
Oh, yeah?
And you were on a table dancing. Oh. not a table, sorry. You were on it was a table, but it was next to a bar counter and there was two other girls on the bar counter dancing. Was that kind of carry on going on last night?
Not quite.
Have you tamed a small bit?
No, definitely. There was no taming last night. Oh, my God. There were shots. I never told you there were shots.
Oh, jeez. No wonder you're fucking sick. What kind of shots were you drinking?
Oh, I think there was just one. At the very end of the night, it's a little bit cloudy. I shout out to Lou if she's listening. She pretty much put me in a taxi home.
Oh, nice one. And you got the bus in. You stayed at my mum and dad's house.
I got the bus in. I was like...
Aren't you very lucky to be married to me, really? Like, you know, to have that accommodation. Like.
And that they minded our kids. Yeah. And you got a night off here by yourself.
Excuse me. A night off? I was flat out here minding the dog. All right.
That dog, but actually, that is the way to do it. I actually think get somebody to mind the kids. Then the husband can take over the kids the following day. Do you know? When I came home, what time was it? 2 o'clock. And I went to bed then for 2 hours. Mm. But like... There's no way you'd have wanted to take them for two hours today if
I barely want to take them sober.
I know. No, but I mean, if you'd had them all last night and this morning or whatever.
Oh, if I was minding them last night and you arrived home at 2 o'clock, I'd be like, here you go, babe. Because like, literally, you came home and I was just about to make something to eat. And I was like, I'm off out there now, babe, to the pub. I'm going to watch the Everton match. Because we got rid of all the channels here a few months back. And I kind of said to myself, what I'll do now is when Everton are playing, I'll go out and I'll watch it. But you came in and you were like dead warmed up. And you were like, oh, babe, please.
I was like, no, oh my God. Because I had just been thinking that what I just said about it's great now to, he'll be fresh for the kids. Like, he hasn't seen them, so he'll be, it's grand. I can go away for as long as I need.
Now, I did try, I took 15 magic mushrooms last night.
What?
Yeah, 15 ones from about 2 years ago, but they were duds.
You never told me that.
Oh, sure, I'm only after remembering right now. That, I was like, why was I so fresh? Because I was like, oh, because that was another thing as well. We're coming into magic mushroom season, and I really want to do a trip this year because I didn't do a trip at all last year. But there, I had remnants from 2 years ago still. Just, there was about 15 or 16 of them, and I just said, fuck it.
Are they illegal?
Are they illegal? It's, they are illegal by the law. Yeah, they are.
So the same, like, for you to go and pick up a mushroom and eat it?
Well, like... Sorry, no. They're not illegal. They're illegal if you dehydrate them, if you dehydrate them and try to sell them. I think.
Oh, like,
do
yeah.
You know what I mean,
yeah.
I don't think they're illegal for you to consume. It's kind of like cannabis. Now, if you get caught, they leave you off with like, if you have.
But
like
it's the intent to sell, isn't
like
it?
It's intent basically
to sell. But why I ask is because these mushrooms grow wild in Ireland.
Liberty, they fucking are so abundant, Noel. Liberty that's gaps. Psilocybin is the active ingredient in.
That's
silence.
Why I was wondering, because they're just outside, they're pretty much outside people's doors. So how could you eating something that's there beside it is a carrot or you know growing and whatever? How is it actually illegal for
you?
Go
into a, if you want me to go into a whole debate into that, do you know what?
No, it's not about that.
No, because I like, they shouldn't be, is my roundabout answer. They shouldn't be illegal. They're like used now. There's studies now on psilocybin, right, which is the active ingredient inside in Liberty Gaps, which is the magic mushroom, right? And like proper, legitimate, recognized studies where they can eliminate depression from people. They're used for people with mental illnesses. They're used for, they've been successful with alcoholics and addicts from recovering completely from, you know. No, I'm not saying go out there now and pick a load of magic mushrooms. I take them completely for, I take them for spiritual reasons. I find them healing, and I find every time I've gone on a trip, a proper trip, I've always had an experience that I've taken into what I would consider this, which is the real world. And have you, and have, like, empathy is a big one for me. I'm not saying I'm not empathetic, or I'm not saying I wasn't empathetic, but I didn't have natural empathy. I didn't have massive amounts of natural empathy for the plight of others. But around the time I became a vegetarian, I went on a trip.
All right.
And it was around the time, and I remember coming out of the trip and deciding I'm going to be a vegetarian, and a lot of my friends at the time were vegetarians as well. Conspiracy John, my sister was a vegan, my other sister's a vegetarian, and I'd been talking to them about it. But I went on this trip anyway, and I'm not saying it's the reason, there was a variety of other reasons as well, but once I came out of it, I just had a different perspective on soul.
Oh Jesus.
Yeah. And on where soul exists. And I think it exists in us, but I think it exists in animals as well. And I'm, as you well know, and if you want to listen to the Patreon, you'll hear me give out massively about our eating experience in a couple of places. But you'll have to tune in and listen to that. It's only the price of a cup of coffee. But $2.50, link in the bio. And half price for a minimum period.
Stop.
It's going up to $5 then, like, which is the price of a pint. For less than press, but what the fuck was I saying? Oh yeah, I can't. I just had No, I just had a fucking, like, I, you know, recently I was like, oh my God, I just would love a burger. Oh my God, I would just, I really fancy a fucking bit of fish or whatever. Like, do you know what I mean? I'm having that recently. But like, I just, I don't think, I never say never, never say never, but I don't think I'm going to go back there. But that all came, that type of, not, I won't say kindness, but I'd say an unusual empathy that I didn't have before, I now have. And it's kind of annoying because I love the taste of steak. But anyway.
So that was, I don't know how, oh yeah, you were on the bus. So yeah. And then we went to Voodoo Rooms, which is the nightclub, the 90s, what's the team? I don't know. But that all is there. It gets very vague there. And I was, yeah.
Did you get the shift?
I got the shift, yeah. It was grand.
He dropped the hand.
More Prosecco and everything in there, like, and we had a table, which was great. And then I was put in a taxi by Louise. I didn't want to go. I was talking to her about it.
Didn't you?
No.
Oh, were you a bit tick?
I got bowled. I don't think I did.
Did you get bowled?
I don't think so. I don't think so. You can get bowled.
But just for the listeners out there, this woman here can get rightly bowled after a drink.
I don't think I did. I just remember going, But then, in fairness, she had warned the taxi man to warn me to contact her when I got home. But I did. Well, I did two missed calls, and then I caught the third call. But that was after I got lost around the apartment.
They were ringing you to see if you got home. You must have been fucking moldy altogether, were you?
I know, but she just wanted to make sure when you're sending somebody off in a taxi by themselves, like...
Right, okay. I'll have to fucking do a bit of forensic digging here now to see what went on here.
But then it doesn't help when I couldn't find the apartment door. Yeah. But that happens. Your mother was telling me that it happened, Anthony, loads.
Well, they're my parents, and I'd find it difficult to find their apartment. It's very difficult to find. It is unusual, like.
Yeah.
It's like the Twilight Zone.
So it was a great night. But it has now. I think I like a few glasses of wine. Or Prosecco or whatever, but I genuinely think that it's poison. Like, it's such poison.
Prosecco?
Prosecco and wine.
Yeah.
Like, in comparison to, I've gone back down to vodka in general, if I'm having a drink, and it's vodka and sparkling belly gone with a dash of lime or something. And I feel then that you're getting way more, you're kind of counteracting the alcohol a bit with the amount of water that you're drinking, so you're not as dehydrated or something.
But you're definitely putting more water in, like, whereas if you're drinking wine, you're just drinking wine.
Yeah, and
if you're drinking beer, you're just drinking beer.
Yeah.
This holiday will be known as the Guinness and red wine holiday for me, because, like, that's what I was drinking, Guinness and red wine. And I haven't drank wine in ages, and I forgot how much I love red wine. I think white wine is piss. I think it's pure fucking, like, vinegary piss. Mm. Like, there's something luxuriant about a glass of red wine.
And you it's definitely easier for you to find a red wine you like than a white wine.
Yeah, they're all piss. And I'm not a fucking, I don't know a good glass of white from a bad glass of white, because they're both piss. But I do know if a red is nice. Like, for example, now. This is pretty fucking nice. What is it? A Malbec?
Malbec, yep.
I fucking don't know anything about it. It's nice, though, like.
It's nice.
Consonants, it does nice.
Well, you know that, like, I'll always remember you thought house.
Shut up now, don't be telling everyone the secrets to our past.
Huh? I just have the house. Huh? Huh? House white? Huh? Huh? You thought it was like Pinot Grigio or whatever.
Thomas brand.
Bless.
Which I suppose, fuck it, it is a brand somewhere down the line. #Spain.
#Spain. Oh, they were in the Women's World Cup, right?
They were.
Yeah, they won, did they?
They beat England.
Oh, yes. 1-0. You were delighted.
I
didn't watch any
of it. I was delighted. I don't like England because of their genocidal past towards us.
Your father doesn't like England either. He was going for Spain this morning.
Oh, does he? Yeah. Well, most Irish people don't like England, to be honest. But no, don't get me wrong now. There's loads of English people that I like. Loads of lovely English people that I like. Like, your brother-in-law is lovely. Gentleman.
Yeah.
You know, Anthony's mum and dad, lovely people. English people, a lot of English people are dead sound. But in general, they're colonising brutality, kind of... You know, the past. I just can't get over it.
Yeah. Do you know what I mean?
So if they're playing a soccer match, I'll go for the other team. So I was delighted that Spain won, but I didn't watch it because I watched a little bit of the women's World Cup at the start, and I just didn't think the games were good. To be honest, I just didn't think they were good. The ones that I watched, and I watched the Ireland ones as well. Watched a bit of the Ireland match, the first Ireland match, and the second half of the second match. I missed the Nigeria game, but I just didn't. I was like, fucking, it's bad enough watching the men play shit, like, do you know, national team, or national men's team, are dog shit, like, and the women, in fairness, they did get to the World Cup now, in fairness, like, but I just thought the standard was crap.
Well, like, soccer is not exciting, like, to watch anyway.
It depends on who you're watching, Noel. If it's so not exciting if you're watching a shit team. Like, if you watch... like, I'm supposed to be going to the Ireland-Dutch game now in a couple of weeks' time, right? In the Aviva. And, like, Holland are a good... Holland played the game the way it's supposed to be played. Ireland are trying, to their credit now. We have a manager who's trying to get us to play. And I watched Vera Paul's team. I just thought they were banal. And poor, and you know me, I love soccer. Like, I just thought they were fucking banal. Maybe we just don't have the players. But anyway, I'm delighted Spain won anyway, knocked England out. Fucking
very good. Next topic.
Hashtag Luna dash 25.
Dash 25.
Semicolon. Luna semicolon 25. We're a half an hour into the fucking episode.
I don't know what this is about.
Do you remember what this, at the start I said before we did this, I was like, we'll just do half an hour now tonight.
Yeah, and I was like, that's never ever the case. But you think that in your own little head there, darling.
I was just like, yeah, well, yeah. But then you said, sure, sometimes we'd be doing trending topics and we still wouldn't even be at half an hour. And here we are going on to Luna semicolon 25 and we're half an hour into the podcast. So what that is, it was a Russian ship that was trying to land on the moon.
Oh yeah?
But lost control and crashed into the moon.
Was it just an there was no astronauts?
There was no humans in it, no. Astronauts. It was, AI generated or whatever.
So they couldn't land. Oh, and it just crashed.
So it just crashed into the moon. You know?
Jesus.
What do you think of the moon?
It's lovely.
Do you like it?
Big fan of the moon. This is good, riveting content. This is going to really drive people over to the Patreon.
For less than $2.50 a month, lads.
What do you think of the moon? It is lovely. Grind. Any other words? I do like the moon and stars.
Yeah.
I haven't a clue about them.
Well, now that you mentioned the stars, I was going to say what you think of the stars next. I know you said the stars as well, but like when we were on holidays, which you can listen to the full Patreon for only $2.50, right?
If there's anything left for them to hear on it, one of the nights kept talking about it.
Well, one of the nights that when we got the bellies down to bed, you and I sat out with our glasses of red.
Mm.
I don't think it was Malbec. Maybe it was. It could have been a Shiraz.
Shiraz.
It could have been we were on the Raz with a Shiraz. But you and I were sitting back and we were watching the sunset come down, and there was a couple of hills in front of us, and there were a couple of wild horses in the field. And the sky was illuminated by these little tiny little dots of stars.
It's pretty cool, all right.
It wasn't dark. It was 85% dark, but it was like dusk is the word that I was looking for. But you could see the silhouette of the horses as they were running up and down. And it was like there was a moment there where we were just like, it's fucking pretty cool
for camping. Like the horses were dancing in the sunset. Like it was pretty class. It was pretty epic. And then, like, we just managed to get home before the big storm, so that made it even better.
But there's another, there's about four or five unbelievable twists and turns now, lads.
Yeah.
That we won't disclose,
yeah.
But for only $2.50 a month, lads.
Patreon.
Get on to the fucking Patreon. Anyway, that's Luna 25, Russia. Watching the Russians.
Oh, for fuck's sake, Connor.
Listen, our fucking job is to talk, all right? So, like, I'm...
I don't get paid for this at all.
You're getting... What are you talking about? You're not getting paid. You're fucking getting paid week in, week out.
Oh, yeah, I forgot that, though. Yeah. Sorry, Daddy, sorry.
Yeah.
Sorry, Connor. Oh, sorry about this. Keep filming now.
I just need to... Like, we have to talk about shit. We have to pretend we're fucking interested. What do you think about the Russians? Have you ever been to Russia?
Right.
Ali, Ian, stop it. Come on. Cadastu.
That's what it reminds me of.
Have you ever been to Russia?
Have you ever? Come on. Come on, Roberto.
Come on, Ron. Cadastu did. I rob air.
Have you ever been to Russia? Come on.
Well, I'm trying to fucking spark conversation. You're giving me fuck all back.
Sorry, I thought we were moving. Have you got something else to talk about?
No, this is the last. Russia. I'm trying to give the game a fair shot. We overshot on the out. We gave Spain a fair fucking crack off the whip. You're trying to fucking lock the door here on Luna hashtag / semicolon 25. And we're I'm trying to like
semicolon. It's changed now.
It's either fucking dash or hashtag or fucking brackets semicolon end brackets.
What is
motherfucker? Have you ever been to Russia? Yes or no? Are you a spy? What's your earliest memory of anything Russian?
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, there you go. This is what interviewers do. They fucking ask that difficult questions. They put you into spots where you're not comfortable.
I do like that Americans program, which we must get back to watching.
Oh, that was very good.
That's really good. We need to get back. We could definitely go at that from the start again.
Oh, I would watch that from the start again. Yeah, want to give the listeners a kind of a little synopsis from what we've seen that.
Oh, it's about Russian spies living in America.
But they're deep spies.
Deep, yeah. They're like, and it's like goes into like, they're like, they've got kids and everything in America and they're fully American and they were in a camp from when they were kids.
KGB.
to be spies, yeah. Like to be American spies.
They were trained implanted. As children to be spies. Like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And implanted in America. So it just goes.
And it's edge
that.
Of your seat kind of stuff. It's on Disney actually, I think.
Oh, I think it's on one of them now. Yeah.
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 But we'll watch that and we'll let you know about that on the Patreon, lads. Right. We're not going to be giving away our thoughts on this fucking channel. Right for fuck all.
Do you know what's very topical that is the Tyson Fury at home at the Furies?
We've been watching.
Watch that, people, if you're interested.
That is very cool. And do you know what's interesting? What do you find interesting about that?
Well, I think they're just a good, interesting family. It's interesting, and Tyson Fury is bipolar, and it's interesting the way they talk about it.
And you've experienced, but like we've both experienced, obviously. You've experienced it more than me, but like bipolar is in your family as well. Like,
So it's a different type. He seems to go up and down more like regularly, like days, you know, a few days up, a few days down. Kind of, it's very cycling. I think, I don't know.
But you see, you don't know what the editing is saying.
Well. Like, yeah, you don't know what the editing. They do mention it a lot, like in it so far.
Well, I have to say now, I threw it on here the other day, kind of Maria wasn't even that.
Yeah, it was.
The lads were here and they were annoying us, and you and me were wrecked. And I was like, "Look, let's just fucking throw this on," and it's pretty good. Like Tyson Fury is the heavyweight champion of the world, the Gypsy King. He's from a traveler background, and he's married to what's the girl's name? What's her name?
Paris.
Yeah, and they've got 6 kids. They live in a fucking mansion. But then, like, he's like a multi-millionaire.
Yeah, but it's like it's a mansion. That is decked out like a caravan, like, isn't it?
Well, I don't know. I said the other day when they were in the kitchen, I was like, I'd love that kitchen, and you told me it was too gaudy or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, you don't like the style. You're not into the style of it.
No.
Yeah.
But that's. But then, and it was like they're and like they.
But they seem
they're
like
very very. Do you know what I love about it? Right, they've got their own culture. They've got their own. They're very proud of their culture. Like, they're talking about their daughter now, whose name is Venezuela, I swear. Do you know what it's like? It's like the Kardashians for itinerants.
Yeah.
Like, that's what it's like. Like, because they're multi-millionaires. They're flying all over the place. And Tyson Fury gets in fucking a Avari into his head, and they're off to Iceland. The next minute, they're on a fucking boat in Cairns. Then they're fucking going up to Scotland. It's really good. It's really good. We're watching it at the moment. I think we've nearly binge watched it. There's only a couple of episodes left in it.
We've binge watched as much as we can with children now.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, that concludes Trending Topics with Cornelius Patrick O'Sullivan, featuring Noelle Patricia O'Sullivan. How's things?
I think I've gone through how my things are now. I'm tired. and I'm a emotional wreck. But other than that, it's good. Busy week. We had a busy week between holidays and Harvey had a few birthday parties, and I was in Dublin, and then we had out last night. So it was a busy week. But I'm looking forward to the week ahead and trying to get back into a bit of a routine.
And we're doing a live. We're in the Cork Podcast Festival this week.
About that.
It's on Friday, and if you're thinking of going, you can't because it's sold out. We sold out last week, so we're absolutely delighted with that. It's on the Maureen's, which I must check out during the week. I don't even know what the menu is. I don't have a fucking clue. But we've got that this week, and
if anyone's actually going to it, can you let us know? Because we have no idea who's going.
Yeah, we're kind of blown away. Now, it's only a small room, so it's not a lot of tickets, but like, for the tickets to be gone so soon, we were like really, really happy with it. And but we're like speculating, who the fuck is going? Like, who the fuck is going? So we'll find out, and we'll report back to you. So I only have a few things really to talk about. Like, we're back from the holidays, right? Why did we go, and why did we do that type of holiday?
Why did we do it? Well, I suppose we looked up the hotel prices. They were too expensive. We couldn't justify it at the moment. And then I kind of had an idea I would like to try camping anyway.
Yeah.
And so we did it. That's why we decided. I suppose hotels too expensive, and we still wanted to give it a go and see what it'd be like to go away for a few days. But it was a different experience, but it was good.
Was there anything we did that you didn't anticipate happening?
No, not really. I think, like, we were very lucky now, and I think we need to know that, as in everything went well.
Yeah,
everything, the weather
except
was good,
except for that one massive thing that didn't go well that you have to listen to on the Patreon.
Oh yeah, stay tuned. But so I think we might be rose tinted a bit, but no, I think it all was, I mean, the kids enjoying themselves so much. Like, I kind of had heard of that, but it was lovely to see it.
Yeah.
But yeah, I suppose that's it.
Just to swing that question back around on me.
Oh, sorry, yeah. What about you, Con? Always forget that I meant to actually have a conversation with you.
We're back, and why do we go? Great question. Was there anything that... Like, do you know what I... Like, I have to say, I was so busy in the run-in to going away, I didn't give it any consideration at all. And then the day that it happened, the day that we went away, I think it was Monday last week, or was it Tuesday?
Monday.
Dan down here in the morning, because I had to do a load of cocoa stuff. I had a load of stuff to get organised, and then got him in, and then you were packing, we got them all into the car, and we had to get diesel, and then we went off. And then it wasn't until I was kind of really coming out of Limerick that I was kind of going, I don't even know where I'm going. And camping is so far away from what you and I have experienced in our decade with each other. Like,
Yeah. And I think we'll still do that, like, you and I.
Oh.
But I think with the kids,
we are definitely going to be doing hotels.
Just with the kids, it was as easy to be there as to be in a hotel, so.
Absolutely. No, we're definitely... And, like, I mean, I still want to mac it up in a hotel. But what I will say, like, you know, like, I love hotels. I love fucking going away. It's great. We always have time with ourselves that we don't have as much anymore now. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I fucking love it. I love eating out. I love all that. I'm never going to give that up. I fucking love it too much. But what I was really surprised about with the camping was how much I enjoyed it. Even though there was... Now, as you said, conditions were perfect. The weather was good. We weren't going for fucking a long time. You know, everything kind of worked out in a way, except for that big thing that you'd have to listen to the Patreon for. Except for that huge thing that, like, we can't say now, but...
Say no more. Shh.
But, like, in general, like, it was such a pleasant... What was the word you used so many times? Wholesome.
It's very wholesome, yeah.
Wholesome. And there was a lot of wholesomeness. And there was a bit of comfort in the wholesomeness as well.
Mm.
You know, anyway, so we're going to leave the podcast with this last question, right?
Okay. He's sitting up and everything. It must be very important.
So it's a kind of a, it's not a question, it's kind of a thought experiment. This time next year, question Ooh. Mark. So we're coming in to the end of the summer now.
Yeah.
Starting school. Harvey's going into first class. Hunter's going into
Dolphin group.
That's like what is it?
Second year preschool.
So this time next year, Harvey will be in second class and we'll be...
Hunter will be starting school.
Please God, all things going well.
Mm.
Both boys will be going into formal... will be in formal education. We're a year down the line. What... Where would you like us to be? Where would you like this project that we have going on to be at? What would you be happy with?
I suppose, first and foremost, I just want us to be happy this time next year. We're looking a year ahead. Happy and healthy goes without saying.
Yeah.
I mean, we're happy and healthy at the moment.
Let's say it. Let's say it out to the universe.
I want to be happy and healthy.
We're going to be happy and healthy this time next year.
The year behind us to have been successful, be it with me not working anymore.
Mm-hmm.
That your career has gone from strength to strength as it's going.
Yeah.
And that we're, I kind of just want to be, it's kind of in the same place I'm in now in a way.
Yeah. Fuck it, isn't that great though?
With life being as, like, we're pretty content at the moment and happy. Yeah. So I want to be as happy now. And with your career going from strength to strength,
well,
pretty much.
I want the exact same thing. I want to be happy and healthy. I want to do. I'd like to have career progression because what that brings is a little bit more financial stability, and with a little bit more financial stability, then I'd like us to be. I would love next year for us to go. Last year we went to Dublin on our summer holidays for a day.
One night, or two days and one night.
This year we went to Doolin and it was three nights, was it?
Three nights, yeah.
We were three nights away. Next year, I'd love for us to at least go on at least two camping expeditions with all of what you just said behind us. Things going well at work, our health and our happiness at a 10 out of 10. And just fucking driving it on and trying to appreciate it and trying to find the time to appreciate it as well. Because, like, I will say, and I know I was saying there at the start of the podcast, that's the way my mind goes when I'm not working, with frustration and doubts and stuff like that. But for all of that being said, there was enough, the wholesome, and we did everything on the, and I'm not going to give it away because I do genuinely want people to listen to the Patreon, right? But, like, there was a charm to it that, like, I remember fondly holidays. We didn't go on many holidays, but I remember when my parents were young and it was just three, myself, Leona and Susan, they took us to Galway.
Oh,
my parents took us to Galway for something similar to what we did, a couple of days, 3 or 4 days away. And we went to Salt Hill. And we went on the Marys and we stayed in a hotel and we went on a ferry and, you know, and there's photographs still knocking around of the three of us, like, in our 1980s garb, eating a packet of Monster Munch and one of us doing the pizza. And do you know what I mean? And that's a memory that, like, I know Hunter's young and Harvey's young, they're six and they're four. You'd be surprised. I just think... putting that stuff into those boys at this age and continuing to do it just is great for them and great for us as a family.
You're gonna cry?
I'm not gonna cry. Please leave me alone. All I'm trying to do is express my feelings here on this podcast. Conversations with Cornelius. You're not much for well, what about the ride that we were kind of half talking about? Is that kind of off the table now as well? Guys, if you like this podcast and you have no money and you'd like to support us, right, you can leave a review. You can go on to Apple or iTunes, or you go on to Spotify and give us one of those 5-star reviews. They're absolutely brilliant. If you feel like writing down a few words, it helps so much. You've no idea how much it helps the algorithm.
Like, share, subscribe.
Liking, share, and subscribe. I meet so many people who tell me, I love your podcast. It's absolutely fantastic. And I always say the same thing to them. I'm always like, thank you so much. I really appreciate the support. And I genuinely do. But like, comment, subscribe, guys. that takes us over the edge. That brings us to the next spot. You might think, what's the point of me fucking sharing this now on my Instagram stories? There's only 22 people that follow me. We just want everybody to get it. And like those 22 people, one or two of those might become long-term listeners. And that just helps us out enormously. It helps us live our dreams. And anyway, sure, look, that's it. There's no more to say, really.
Happy Sunday. Happy Monday from tomorrow. But when we out.
Yeah, all right. Okay. Love you.
Bye.